Because people know American in Paris as a great iconic movie with this, you know, great ballet sequence in it, we decided why not actually tell the story using a ballet, jazz, Broadway vocabulary right from the get-go.
I feel like we haven't nailed it to any particular decade in the way the music's presented. And that's the feedback I'm getting, especially from young people, is it feels like a fresh new score.
It is an American in Paris, a new musical, and we really did. We wrote a new book. We pulled in a lot of new music. Of course, all the choreography and the design is new. So it stands on its own, I think. Yet, what's interesting is people that do know the movie and love the movie also love the show.
The way she holds her knife, the way she danced till three, the way she changed my life, no, no, they can't take that away from me.
The romance in our story is so potent because it comes from a place of darkness that couldn't really be really truthfully and honestly explored in the 1950s because it was still so close to the war. These relationships, this love, the joy, the spirit, it's bubbling under the surface and eventually gets to kind of just explode out.
It's that kind of love that takes your breath away when you see them.
In that moment where she meets Jerry, it's the arrow striking, and I don't think she can quite believe it.
Audiences really connect with the idea of, you know, ideal love, and or not even ideal love. It's not ideal, it's just true love. It's just that thing, that potent thing that, you know, if you're lucky in your life, you get to experience.
It's wonderful, it's marvelous, she should care for me.
In life, something unexpected can happen, and you meet someone, and then you know.
It will take you in places you never believed you could go.